يا قوم إنما هذه الحياة الدنيا متاع وإن الآخرة هي دار القرار.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. This was the statement of a man that was hiding his iman from the people of Fir'aun. The people meaning the civilians at that time around the time of Fir'aun in the chapter of Ghafir, chapter number 40, verse number 39, where he mentions, Ya Qawmi, and he says, O my people, اتبعوني أهدكم سبيل الرشاد, follow me, I will guide you to the right way. And Rashad is the opposite of Ghay, and Ghay is acting in contradiction to the knowledge. You are not acting in accordance to the knowledge that you may have. But ar-rashad, ar-rushd, is acting in accordance to the knowledge that you have. When he says, ahdikum sabil ar-rashad, let me guide you to the straight path. And notice the uslub that he uses here, the method. He says, oh my people, follow me, I'll guide you to the right path. Then right after that, he says, ya qawmi again. Oh my people, innama hadhi al-hayatu dunya mata'. That verily the life of this dunya is an enjoyment. The word mata', we've probably heard this word before when we make hajj. At-tamattu' means a brief enjoyment between the two time periods of hajj, of the nusuk. So this world is a mata', is an enjoyment. And subhanAllah, seeing that similarity with tamattu' is the same similar event, that any enjoyment in this life will be temporary. And that's what he reminded them of. And having that mentality is the means of Rashad. It is the total guidance. It is the means of guidance. That when you remember this life is temporary, then what is eternal? وَإِنَّ الْآخِرَةَ هِيَ دَارُ الْقَرَارِ. That verily the next life is that which is eternal. So the mu'min, the believer, they look at it from a bigger picture. They realize everything in this life is a manifestation of God's creation that is here for a purpose. We worship Allah by indulging upon those things to show gratitude to Him, realizing that it's all going to end. So the greater purpose is to show gratitude to Him by using these things and that which is beneficial for our development. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was lying on a mat in hadith by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, and it's on a Tirmidhi with hadith Hassan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was lying on a mat, and the athar of the hasir was on him, and they saw like the marks when he woke up. They saw the marks on him, ala jambihi kama qala Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and they said, "Ya Rasulullah, law ittakhadhna laka wata'an." He said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, if we were to take for you a bed, I mean, you're laying on a mat, and we see the effects of the mat on you." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, putting things in proper perspective. He said, "Mali wa ad-dunya." He said, "What is for me in this dunya?" Mali wa ad-dunya. إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّ لِي مِنَ الدُّنْيَا مِثْلُ رَاكِبٍ إِسْتَظَلَّ تَحْتَ شَجَرَةٍ ثُمَّ قَامَ وَتَرَكَهَا أو ثُمَّ رَاحَ وَتَرَكَهَا. He says, what is for me of this life? Verily, the comparison of me with this life, or the relationship between me and this life, is like a rider that goes under the shade of a tree, uses it to get his breath, then gets up and leaves and continues his journey. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Abdullah ibn Umar, "Kun fi dunya ka annaka gharib," be in this world as though you were a stranger, or abid sabil, or a wayfarer. This life is temporary. Use it to make sure that you are investing in the next life. Fudail ibn Ayyad, rahimahullah ta'ala, asked the man, "Kam alayka min as-sana?" Or min as-sinin. The man said, "Sittun sana." He said, سِتُّونَ سَنَةً وَأَنْتَ تَسِيرُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يُوشِكُ أَنْ تَبْلُغُ. He asked the man, "How old are you?" The man said, "I'm 60. And Fudail ibn Iyad responded, thinking of the Akhirah, remembering that this life is temporary. He said, "For 60 years, you have been traveling to your Lord, and you are almost there. يُوشِكُ أَنْ تَبْلُغُ." So look at this mentality, look at this approach. How do we approach this dunya? Let's remember that this dunya is, as Umar ibn al-Khattab mentioned to some of his companions, when he saw a trash can, he pointed at the trash can and he said, "Hadhihi dunyakum allati tahrisuna alayha," that this is your dunya that you cherish. So let's make sure that we do not cherish this dunya to the degree that it diverts us from the straight path, that it diverts us from remembering that which is everlasting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you.
Listen, guys, corona or not, we are committed to continuing our quality da'wah, bringing you the services and securing the funds for this masjid and its programs, even if virtually. Make sure you hit the link below and be of those who help carry this masjid, even though it's empty.